Hello everybody and welcome to another Space Engineers tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to set up a gravity drive. Now traditionally gravity drives are used to move very very large ships, because making very very large ships move with a lot of thrusters requires a ton of them. So people often would then use a gravity drive to propel their ships. Now first let me explain what a gravity drive is. A gravity drive is a ship that uses artificial mass blocks and gravity generators to propel itself forward. Now in this ship I have two gravity drive cells, so to say. So I have one here up front and I have one here at the back. Now in each of these cells, in its center, now you can't actually see it here, because if I were to remove the blocks around it, I would also detach the gravity generators that are attached to it. But you're going to have to take my word for it that right at the center of this thing here, there's an artificial mass block. And right in the center here as well, there's also one of these mass blocks. Now, as you can also see, there's a gravity generator in each direction. Now this gravity generator, for instance, if this gravity generator were to activate, the one at the back here, it would generate a gravity field that will push you in this direction. Now normally what this would mean is that I were to be able to walk on this end like so. But because I also have a mass block at the center here, it will push that mass block in that direction, and therefore push the entire ship in that direction, because the ship is attached to the mass block. In this way you can push a ship forward without actually using any thrusters. Now, if you then put a gravity generator in each direction, you could imagine that like this you could control your entire ship using gravity generators. Now this ship here is one of how I would make such a ship. Now it has a cockpit back here, where we could sit in it and control it with WASD. But we're not going to use it. We're completely going to control the ship using buttons, which are set up to do different things. And here are the buttons in question. Now I'm going to maneuver the ship towards this beacon in a bit, but first I'm going to show you how I set up these buttons. So let us jump in here. This button panel here has four actions set up. Each action controls the rotation, in this particular case, of the ship in one direction. So if this timer block here, or this first button, if I were to press this, this timer block goes on, which I named timer block go left. And then another one here, go right, go up, go down. Now I think what I intend to do here is quite obvious, but let me just show you how it would work. So let's see if I've got the mass blocks turned on. This is something I have to check real quick. Are the mass blocks turned on? They sure are. Okay, so if I were to... So these buttons are set up to turn left, turn right, turn up, turn down. So if I were to turn left, for instance, keep your eye on the beacon, you can see the ship turns left a bit. If I were to do this, I'll press the second button, we go right, up, and down. Now how I set this up is, when I press this button, the gravity generator that pushes the front of the ship towards the left, that will be the one on the right. That's to keep everything simple and not confusing. But this gravity field that is being activated here will create a gravity field that pushes the block in this direction. In other words, this block, this mass block in the center here, will fall in that direction, basically. So I press this button, that gravity generator activates, and it gets pushed in that direction. The exact opposite is true on the back end of the ship, on the second gravity drive. If this mass block If we want the ship to go left, we need this pod, this gravity drive here, to turn to the right. So if it were to, if the ship in itself, in its entirety, were to turn left, you want this end to go to here. Therefore, the exact opposite of the front gravity drive is true here. This mass block needs to go in this direction, therefore the mass block on the left, which I named gravity generator right, because it pushes this pod to the right. You can push this entire ship to the side. Let me just show you how I set that up in the buttons. Okay, right here. So I've got this whole set of gravity generators. Now, back, this first word here is where the gravity generator itself is. If it's in the back gravity drive, it says back here. If it's in the front, it says front. And then afterwards, it says the direction in which the gravity field pushes. Now, this also means that when it says left, it is actually on the right side of the gravity drive, because it will push the gravity block to the left. Now, this is a bit confusing, but once you get a hang of it and fiddle with it a little bit yourself, it will make sense quite quickly. So when I try to set up the actions for this, or when you set up the actions for this, you want to activate a timer block, which will first, the timer block would then, for instance, be here, go left. You want to turn the gravity on of the front left and the back right. So this will turn the entire ship to the right. You also want to start a timer, which will turn them off again. Oh, these can go. So this stop left, which you activate with the one here. I had that set up here. You see here, timer block stop left. Then after 1 second of the gravity generators being turned on, you turn them off again. So that means you've got a quick pulse in which the ship moves to the left. Afterwards, the gyroscope will stop the motion again. So if I were to press it, it turns on for a second and then turns off again. You can see it in my speed in the bottom left corner. For a moment I move to the left and then it stops. Now to the right, up and down, it's set up the exact same way. So I can move my ship to the right, it turns on for a little bit and then turns itself off again. This makes it very easy to control and steer the ship in the direction you want to go. Okay, almost there. Yes. One more. There we go. Now I want to go up. Yep. Up we go. And this is more or less okay. Now for the forward motion, or any motion of the ship in its entirety, and by which I mean I don't need a rotation but an actual motion of the entire ship, it is important that the thruster in the direction of motion is turned off, because otherwise the inertial dampeners of the ship will automatically try to stop it. So if this thruster were to now be turned on and I were to activate my gravity drive in the forward direction, it will try to stop it. Now in a very large ship you would not have enough thrust to fight this gravitational field, so it wouldn't be that big of an issue, but because we have a somewhat smaller ship here, it's you do need to turn the thrusters in that direction off, otherwise it won't work. Besides that, the setup is again the same as the last one. I've got these set up to the 1 and 2 buttons here. Let me show you. So the first one triggers the timer block that I named go forward, and the second one go back. What this however will do is it will give a small pulse to the forward motion. So, yeah, let me show it once again here. It will activate the gravitational generators that will push the blocks forward, and it will once again stop this or turn these gravity generators back off after 1 second. However, because we are now moving in one direction and we no longer have any thrusters to stop us, it will continue to move in this direction at that speed. So if I click this, you see we accelerate to 4.6 meters per second. You can see it in the bottom left corner, and we slowly start to approach this beacon. If I were to press this button again, we accelerate further to 9.6. If I want to slow down again, I can press the backwards button, which is 2. You see we slow down, and we press it again, we slow down to about 1 meter per second. Now, this is not a perfect system, so you might want to also have a few thrusters set up on the one hand to keep it moving in a straight line, but also to slow it down the very last bit of your motion. And that's where I've got this third button set up for. This third button activates once again a timer block, which turns the gravity drive on and off. And by that I mean it turns the mass block on or off, the mass blocks I mean, so both of them, and it will turn on these thrusters that I had turned off to make sure we can move forward. Now, the reason you would want to turn the mass blocks of these ships on or off is you want to turn them on, of course, to move, but also you might want to turn them off if you approach a station or some other gravitational field, because this mass block at the center will not just be affected by the gravitational field of the gravity drive, but also of gravitational fields of, for instance, a station or a large ship you pass by. And of course this will interfere with your motion. Therefore, you might have occasions where you want to just fly around with just thrusters, because otherwise your ship will fly off in some random direction. Now, for the final button here, I have the gyroscope, which I have on this ship, toggle on off. I can show you here in the settings. Now, what you could then do is, once the gyroscope is turned on, it will stop rotational motion. So if I were to start moving left, oh, hold on, let me turn the gravity drive back on, otherwise we're not going to see much happen here. Yes, so now the gravity blocks are turned on again. Once I press this button, it will stop its rotation as soon as the gravity is turned off again. So as soon as this gravity generator that is turning us left is turned off, the gyroscope corrects the motion and stops it again. If I were to, however, turn this gyroscope off, it will not stop this motion. So you will move to the left constantly until you either press the button in the opposite direction or turn the gyroscope on again. So let me really quickly show you how this would look like. For instance, I were to now turn the left on, I will rotate until such a time that I stop it with the button in the opposite direction, as you can see here. If I were to do the opposite would once again be true. Now, this is a bit difficult to control, so I by default usually have it set up so that my gyroscope is just turned on. So I can now again aim it slowly towards this beacon. You can, by the way, mesh these buttons for the directional motion and of the forward and backward motion. It doesn't matter. Okay, here we go. And we can once again start moving towards this beacon. Let's see if we can ram it. Because of reasons, why not? Okay, slightly up, I would say. Yep, to the right more. No, to the left, left. I want to ram it. No! Aw, we missed. Sorry, guys. Anyway, so this is my gravity drive. I hope you found this tutorial useful. If you have any questions, don't be afraid to ask. I'll try to elaborate in the comments, and if you still don't understand, maybe I'll just make a follow-up video of this and build it in some more detail. But I think it's clear as it is. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and I see you next time.